Welcome to my Texas workshop. I'm Randy Lammers.
I'm Aaron Keevan.
This is Worth Knowing. How would you like to assemble with accurate load in less time and simplified inspection? Direct tension indicators, an RCSC specified component, accomplishes just that. We would like to welcome our guest today, Chris Kirvin from Applied Bolting Technology. Chris, welcome to the Texas Workshop.
Thank you. Thanks for having me. I appreciate being here.
Hey, so Chris, you guys are an awesome company. Tell us about Applied Bolting.
We're a Vermont-based business that makes DTIs, direct tension indicators. Mm-hmm. They're designed to make bolt installation easy and inspection easy as well.
So Chris, I remember back in the 1970s, I was selling DTI washers, and I think we bought them from Bethlehem Steel. So these washers have been around for a while.
Well, Randy, hold on a second. We're not talking about washers here. We're talking about DTIs, or direct tension indicators. So okay, what are DTIs, and what are some of the different styles we see?
Sure. Direct tension indicators are single-use mechanical load cells. They tell you or indicate when the bolts have reached at least the minimum required pretension when they're installed in structural steel.
So let me reiterate that then. So they're really not washers because you use them with a washer.
They're often referred to as washers, but no, they're load cells for each and every bolt.
They're load cells. Okay, that's important to understand.
And you've got a few different types with you, so can you kind of go through what you have here?
What we have is our standard DTIs that are inspected with a feeler gauge. Then we have our squirter and DuraSquirt DTIs, which are installed, inspected to the aid of the orange indication material. So when the bolts are tensioned, it pops out the orange mark. The installers and the inspectors can see that the bolts are tight.
Okay. All right, so how are these produced? Okay, they're load cells. I get that. So you're having to have a specific load that you're manufacturing these to. How do you get there? What do you do?
The bumps on the DTI need to be strong. They need to be rigid. They need to resist compression.
Okay.
So they're strong. And when the compression becomes so great from tightening a bolt and the joints squeeze together, these bumps will flatten out. And when they flatten out, it lets us know that bolts have been tightened. So it's the shape of the bump.
Right.
It's the shape of the well, it's the thickness of the material, and it's also the heat treat.
Yeah, no, that makes good sense. So it's all a factor of those things. Material, heat treat, bump geometry, all gives us the compression load, and they're made to a specific load. Yeah.
Yes, exactly. And those loads are prescribed by the Research Council on Structural Connections.
Back to our book every time on our specifications. All right, that makes good common sense.
And then another standard that these are held to is to an ASTM standard. What standard is that, Chris?
Sure, we make the DTIs in accordance with ASTM F959. That's the manufacturing specification. The installation specification, if you will, is the RCSC.
Okay, that makes good common sense. So Chris, so what materials and what finishes do the DTIs come in?
Sure, our DTIs are made from 1045 carbon steel, and we deliver those plain uncoated, and then we can also mechanically galvanize them and thermally diffuse zinc.
Okay.
Now, we also have weathering steel type 3 available.
All right, I'm gonna ask this question because it's gonna get asked. Have you made them in stainless yet?
No, we haven't. Generally speaking, we stick with 1045 carbon. It's what we know.
Okay.
We are open to suggestions, but 1045 carbon steel.
Well, and carbon steel is what the structural industry uses.
Exactly.
Yes.
Right.
Thank you, gentlemen. Yeah,
so that makes good common sense.
All the flaying materials, everything, it's all steel. So
that's right.
Exactly right. Now, what sizes are we talking about? I would imagine they probably closely align to the RCSC book.
Yeah, RCSC covers half inch through inch and a half on installation.
Okay.
ASTM also covers half inch through inch and a half. We do have special requests for 449 and 354 bolts that are bigger in diameter.
Okay.
So beyond inch and a half, we've done it for wind towers and some specialty construction items.
And then that based on the customer giving you also the compression load they're looking for.
Right, so when we do go beyond ASTM F959, we have to have the engineer tell us what tension they want.
Okay, now you also have very specific markings that are important. that you mark all of these washers. You're going to teach me that these are load cells and they're not washers. So we want to make sure you all pick up on this. Load indicators. What are your special markings you have there?
Sure. Yes. The DTIs are marked with a company logo. They're stamped also with a 120 and 325 and a 150 and 490. Tell us what grade of fastener they go with. And then they're stamped with a lot number. So that's the traceability part. And those markings are spaced around the DTI so we know where to insert the feeler gauge for standard DTIs.
And that's stamped on each individual washer. So on the job site, there is really no mix-ups.
Right, so there's, if you ever have a question, what lot of DTIs am I using, unlike a bolt where it's not marked, the DTI is marked, and so it's easy to see.
Okay, very good. Well, I know you brought a Skidmore load cell with you today, and we're going to do some demonstrations. So we're going to show you just exactly how these parts work, how you do inspection. So, Chris, let's go over to the demo table, and let's do some demonstrations.
Great, let's do that.
Okay, fantastic. We're at our demonstration table, and Chris, you've brought the Skidmore load cell with you today. So we're going to see how these load up, because these are actually load cells themselves. So start with, of course, always safety. We have our safety glasses on, and Chris is going to be handling the tools, so he has gloves on. Let's start, Chris, with how do you assemble this direct tension indicator? What's the proper way to assemble it?
The easiest way to install a DTI is put it on the nut side so the wrench operator can see the bumps flatten out.
Okay, cool.
So we're going to insert the bolt through our bolt tension measuring device.
Right.
We're going to put the direct tension indicator on, bumps out.
So that really goes then against your steel member?
Yes.
Okay.
This would be our steel in theory up in the structure.
Right.
Bumps out, hardened F436 flat washer, and then our nut.
Okay, hold on. I would have done that wrong. I don't know why. I would have put the flat washer against the steel, but you're saying the flat washer has to go against the bumps.
Yeah, so the DTI goes on, bumps out, then the flat washer. If we don't have that flat washer between the nut and the bumps, we'll grind down the bumps instead of compressing the bumps.
Okay, all right, well, that makes sense. All right, I would have messed that one up. Okay, got it.
So we have that assembly on. Mm-hmm. Now we're going to snug the connection. And for snug, I don't like to focus on the full effort of an iron worker on the end of a spud wrench. I like to focus on bringing the steel plies into firm contact.
Gotcha.
So we can do that with any wrench, any tool, spud wrench or automatic wrench. In this case, we're going to use a non-impacting electric wrench.
That's a big, hefty tool.
It's a real industrial tool.
You don't put small screws together with that.
No, sir. We're putting together big things.
Okay.
So we have a reaction arm. This reaction arm will hit the next web, flange, bolt, finger over. So it's very important that we keep our lead hand behind the reaction arm. Otherwise, it will chop our fingers off. It's a pinch point.
Okay. All right.
So drop the tool on. Got the reaction arm engaged solidly against the next bolt over.
That. Okay.
And now I'm going to tighten it for our pre-insulation verification to 41,000. This is 7/8 A325 bolt. Min tension's 39,000. Okay. 5% more than that would be 41. So I'm going to tighten to 41.
Okay. All right. We have our skid mark. Okay. Right
there. So we achieved 41,000.
All right.
Now we need to make sure that the DTI is open. The feeler gauge touches the bolt shank on at least half the gaps. The gaps are the spaces between the bumps.
So it goes all the way in. So that gap thickness, you're verifying that gap thickness is correct.
Yeah, and for ease of convenience, for convenience sake, we're gonna use a 5-thou.
Okay.
So I'm gonna try and touch the bolt shank, and just so I know I'm touching the bolt shank, I'm gonna put a little bend in this. So it's now our depth gauge. So
I see that.
We have five bumps, five gaps on this DTI. We want to be able to touch the bolt shank in at least three spots for this.
Okay.
So we're trying to prove the DTI to be strong. The bumps are strong enough to resist the compression of the min tension. So there's one entry, two entry, three entry, four entries, five entries.
Okay. All right. So now you've proven that those bumps are strong enough to withstand that load without full compression.
Right. Okay. If we had full compression now, we'd have to examine why the DTI was flat at 41,000, at 105%.
Okay, all right.
Up in the structure, we therefore want to compress it more. So we're gonna demonstrate that now. We're gonna tighten it until the feeler gauges refuse in at least three spots or more.
Okay,
So right. We're just gonna tighten it. And I've picked a random amount, just more tension.
Right.
And now we wanna make sure the feeler gauge
does not
touch the bolt shank in three spots.
Okay, so this is the standard DTI.
Yes.
So your iron worker then has the feeler gauge on them.
Yes.
And they're then up in the air somewhere, and they're doing this install, put the feeler gauge in there, make sure that the bumps are correct, and then they're going ahead and tighten it where then it looks like it's compressed.
Right, and we've done that. Okay. We've compressed the DTI, the feeler gauge is refused all the way around. So it's a difficult job when you're an iron worker, you're up in the structure, you're 100 feet off the ground, you have a 20-pound wrench, and now you're trying to pull out a feeler gauge.
I understand.
We have something easier.
Okay, but I want to say, what did our load end up being?
Oh, sorry, we're at 48,000 pounds of tension now. So the idea was to make sure that we had an open DTI, that the bumps didn't compress at 41, so it's strong, it's rigid, that it will indicate or flatten out above 41,000.
Okay, so 39,000 was your minimum per RCSE guidelines.
Yes.
For 7/8.
Yes.
And you designed then the compression load on these to be above that.
Basically, yes.
Okay, all right. Now, here's the question I'm gonna have for you, Chris. What is the tolerance above that you typically would manufacture to?
So we're trying to hit with ASTM a range of 39 to 47,000 pounds of tension.
Okay.
And that's in compressive strength in a mandrel, in a solid compression load. Here for AISC and RCSC, we're trying to get to 41,000 pounds or more in the Skidmore.
Okay, all right, and you reached that successfully?
Yes.
Okay, excellent. Now, you say you have something better than this?
Yeah, well, imagine being that iron worker with gloves, a 20-pound tool, and trying to pull this out. It's a bit fidgety. So we designed what we call a DuraSquirt DTI.
All right.
That squirts out an orange indication material that makes bolt tension installation inspection visual. So as you compress these bumps, it discharges the orange markers. And those orange markers are a guide to the installer's inspector that the bolts are tight.
So I no longer have to have that little feeler gauge that I'm dropping.
Yes.
Okay, and that's just quick visual, and really just drive your nut down, bolt it up. Once you see the squirts come out, you're fine.
Yes, right.
Okay, let's demonstrate that. That sounds pretty cool.
Great, thank you.
All right. Okay, we've disassembled. Now you have the DuraSquirt washer with you, right?
Yes.
It's got the orange goop in it. Is that what we call it?
Yes, very technical term, yes.
Okay, orange goop, we'll go with that. Okay, so your orange goop, your flat side goes against your structure, and then the F436 flat washer, and then the hex nut. All right, now we're gonna tighten that up, and you're gonna tell me that when the compression is complete, we're gonna see this goop squirt out.
After we've gone past the minimum insulation requirements, in this case, 39,000 plus 5%, so our pre-insulation verification,
right,
we're gonna tighten this until we get complete indication and confirm we're above minimum tension.
All right, let's tighten it up and see the goop squirt out. I see it. Wow, okay. Yep, I see all of the touch points, and there's all the orange goop. So that's it, that's all iron worker has to do.
That's all they have to do. Now, in accordance with RCSC, they have a new section that allows for innovation, new product, new designs. With the DuraSquirt DTI, we can install using that section to complete indication. When we get complete indication, we need to make sure we're above the 41 kips, in this case, the 105%. And
okay,
so we have complete indication, we're above minimum. That's now our installation criteria and our inspection criteria.
So you're done.
That's it, we're done. Now we just go tighten some bolts in the structure.
So you verified, what is your load? I'm just kind of curious on this.
We're about 50,000 pounds.
Right where you want to be.
Yeah,
outstanding. All right, Chris, we're in basically Houston, Texas, East Texas, where we have kind of a tropical climate. Weather is always an issue. It gets very, very hot here. Is this squirt medium affected by temperature?
No, the DuraSquirt DTI and the Squirter DTI material are unaffected by temperature. So we don't care if it's 30 in the morning and 70 in the afternoon. We don't care if it's minus 30 or plus 120 in the afternoon.
Wow.
The DuraSquirt DTI, it works independent of temperature.
You know, I kind of heard this one time. If a human can be there installing, the DTI will work.
Yes,
got
absolutely.
It. Okay, now, I've got this. I told you, we're in the tropical climate. Yeah, it's not that unusual to see these kind of bolts. This really is torque independent, right?
Yes.
And torque's about friction. Friction, we've taught you a lot that torque is all about friction. So this is going to take a lot of friction. Do you think that this will install to the clamp load needed? Let's do it.
Let's do it. We'll find out.
Okay, let's do it.
And let's pretend we're up in the structural steel this time. So
absolutely.
Bolt through the hole, DuraSquirt DTI on.
All right.
Bumps out.
Right.
F436 hardened flat washer, then you're nut.
All right, everything is rusted. The friction on these surfaces is really, really high.
Really high.
Okay.
And so if I was up in the structure, I wouldn't know what the tension was. I would just know if the DTI emitted the orange substance or not, if it squirted or not.
Okay, so let's block this off.
Right, so let's cover up the dial.
All right.
Pretend we're up in the structure.
All right, let's see what happens.
I'm gonna snug the connection again, bring the plies into firm contact.
All right.
After I've brought the plies into firm contact, I'm gonna continue to tighten.
Okay.
Until the gun stalls out.
All right, let's see what happens. Your gun's stalling.
Yeah, I'll give it another bump. Right, exactly. If some doesn't work, give it more.
Yeah.
So what usually happens now is, since we have no indication material,
I have nothing.
The craft, they tell us that, hey, listen, your Squirter DTIs, your DuraSquirt DTIs, they're not working.
That's really not true, is it?
No, well, if you were tightening a bolt in a Skidmore and you didn't get to the minimum tension, what would you do? You would tighten it some more.
I would.
Right, well, that's because we can see the bolt tension. Here we can't, but we're gonna trust that the DuraSquirt DTI is telling us the bolt hasn't been tensioned. There's a torque makeup.
So now it tells us that.
Right, so the friction in the threads of the bolt assembly have consumed our effort. Let's see what bolt tension we have.
Okay.
There's 15,000.
Wow, and that tool is set at what?
500 foot-pounds.
500 foot-pounds, and we only got 15,000?
Right.
But an iron worker doesn't know that. They just know that they did all of this torque. There's no load there.
And it's their favorite gun. It's a $5,000 tool. Did it not work properly? No, the gun worked well, but the bolt was so dry, instead of tensioning the bolt, we're just overcoming the friction.
Okay.
Or trying to.
So these are direct tension indicators.
Yes.
And it indicates the tension's not there.
It tells us when the bolt has been tensioned, and maybe more importantly, when the bolt has not yet been tensioned. So how are we gonna fix this bolt, Randy? How are we gonna get it up to tension?
Well, you would have to continue to tighten it, but it's going to take a lot of torque to do it. So I'd say disassemble and put the correct clean bolt in there.
Yes.
We want to show you one more demonstration, and that is the simplicity of the installation and how quick these install as compared to other methods of RCSE approved installation methods. And the inspector, how simple it is to inspect. So direct tension indicators, the correct load every time. Let's do it.
So I'm gonna tighten these until we get complete indication on each bolt. We've snugged it.
All right.
After snugging, we're gonna work from the middle connection outward.
Okay.
And I'm gonna tighten each one until I get complete indication from the DuraSquirt DTI.
Okay. So that's it. So only thing the iron worker has to do is run the tool until he sees the goop squirt out.
Complete indication, please.
Complete indication.
Thank you.
And then the inspector comes in and goes, all of them give me indication that clamp load is there.
Right, and at a quick glance, the inspector can see if anything was missed as well.
If it was not squirted out.
Yeah.
Outstanding. In conclusion, Direct tension indicators are load cells, and Chris, they're torque independent. Friction really isn't a factor.
No, friction isn't a factor. The DTIs work independent of torque. They tell us when the minimum bolt tension has been achieved.
Yeah, and then temperatures, do we have any concerns there?
No, the DuraSquirt DTI will work from minus 30 to plus 120, so it's temperature independent.
Oh, wow, yeah, it'll work great in Houston, wouldn't it?
They'll work in Houston.
And we talked about a little bit about time when we were doing the demo, so why would what happens there?
Sure, DuraSquirt DTIs are about four times faster than turn of nut because we don't have to match mark anything. Also, inspection is visual. The inspector can walk along and see that the bolts have been tensioned just by using that orange mark as their guide.
Outstanding component. Direct tension indicators provide accurate load with every assembly. Direct tension indicators provide assured clamp load and verifiable assembly. That is worth knowing.
Thanks to Chris Carvin from Applied Bolting Technologies for coming on the show today.
See you next time.